What's up, guys? MiddleAgedGamer here. We're playing Train Simulator 2016 yet again. It's been a while since I've done a video for Train Simulator. I feel like I was getting out of touch with myself. I need to start touching myself is basically what I'm saying in the most polite way possible. And we're going to do a career scenario. I've been wanting to do a wintertime scenario simply because it's in Texas right now. It's starting to cool off. It's starting to feel like it's wintertime. It's even raining a little bit outside, so let's find one here. I know there's one in West Coast Mainline that I've been wanting to do. And let's see. Stone Cold, that might be it. That's Overshop. I think it was, okay, here we go. Chill Wind. That sounds very cold, right? All right, so let's go ahead and do this. It's called a Chill Wind. It's using a Class 86 rail freight sector. Duration's about 30 minutes, medium difficulty. It says starting at Kingmore Yard. Kingmore Yard. Am I saying that right? Probably not. After heavy rain or heavy snowfall, I can't even talk, you are braving the elements and driving an important freight service up to Lockerbie. So it's wintertime. We're on the West Coast Main Line doing some European freight is what it looks like. Let's go ahead and get started. And hopefully I can get level 31 after this. We'll see what happens. Feels weird to be playing this game. Still waiting for the new engine to come out. Using the Unreal Engine, I guess it is. So let's go ahead and get our headlights on real quick. Get the reverser forward inside. We can go ahead and turn the instruments on. There we go. So we can see the gauges a bit better. I guess we can go ahead and get up to 25 and put some sand down just in case. And turn the wipers on with the on the keyboard. Brake is off. Very careful about wheel slip right here. We almost got it, as you can see. Good enough to avoid that though. Can't hear anything in my headphones. I have no clue what's wrong. Let's see if I can fix it real quick. Right, my $1 million wireless headphones that never work are now working. It's always a good sign, right? So it looks pretty pretty desolate outside. I love the rain effects. I love how it's snowing though, so I can't complain. It looks very silent hillish with all the fog and everything. Take a look outside. So we got someone working on the track to the left right there. That's kind of cool. Got two excavators going at it. I'm telling you, they need to combine simulators. Like, I should be able to hop off the train right now and start doing construction simulator. Or go to the port and do ship simulator to another train station or something similar to that. One day it's going to happen. If only I knew how to program, which I don't know how to program, so maybe it will never happen. Oh, we got a train over there to the right as well. Doing some more freight. How do you do, mate? How's it going over there? Oh, they transport. It's a weird looking cargo. What the hell are we transporting? This looks like Freightliner cargo containers is all that is. Okay, just a bit faster there. I like the interior view on here. You can't switch to the right seat, which is kind of weird. It just kind of goes up like that. Alright, so we got 550 points right there. It's a good start. Almost makes it seem like half the scenario is gone, which we know it's not. It's 30 minutes long. We've only been doing this for about a minute or two at the most. So we gotta go 6.3 miles to a stopping point, which I this rate's going to take forever doing 25 miles an hour. Oh, we can go up to 40 miles per hour coming up. And as with all or most European freight, you can only do 75 miles per hour, although I'm sure this locomotive could go quite a bit faster than that. There's another train going on the tracks right there. Passing through. So I guess we're on the slow side of the line. Hopefully we'll get on the main line, go a bit quicker. Assuming at the 40 mile per hour mark, hopefully we're going to get on the main line, maybe. Praying. Can only pray for it to happen. Anyways, if you guys didn't notice or didn't watch, I was doing the Fallout 24-hour stream. I literally fell out with the flu within like 3 to 4 hours and ended up shaking, literally curled up in my bed for like 3 to 4 hours, just feeling like I was dying, literally. So that was fun. Anyways, I'm almost back to 100%. Is that a lake? Is that a lake? More land. More desolate land. Anyways, I'm feeling a bit better now. Still coughing. Got some, lots of mucus. It's hard for me to sleep. When I lay down, I really, really start coughing pretty bad. But when I sit up, it's not really good at all. But definitely feel a lot better than I did, that's for sure. Alright, so we'll be able to get up to 40 miles per hour. Let's go ahead and bump it up here. Still on the service track, as I'm going to call it, or the access road here in Texas, you know what that means. I'm ready to get back on the main track myself. Quick train by here. About 5.25 miles to go to our first stop. Have no clue why we're stopping. A bit curious about that, but I guess we'll find out here in a little bit. Oh, got more excavators to the right over there. So you don't really notice it if you're in cab. All the stuff out to the side right there. Oh, three excavators actually. It's high detail. Very nice. Let's get back in the cab. I love the interior view of this cab. I don't know why. It's just, I guess the gauge is at the bottom. I really like it. So hopefully that doesn't sound weird. Actually, hopefully it does sound weird. Anyways, if you're just tuning in, please, please go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't already. And most of you guys that watch these videos now have been a long time subscriber. I definitely appreciate that. And I definitely appreciate all the comments that you guys leave me in the section below. I still try to reply to all the comments. It's getting harder and harder the bigger the channel gets. And here's my horn right here. Got some people burning trash right there. That's crazy. Yeah, burning trash outside. They're breathing in the fumes, just hanging out, sitting there. That's cool, right? Alright, we're back on the, looks like the high-speed track now. So hopefully we'll be able to get to speed. So it says you can go 105 again. Do not go 105, you can only go to a maximum speed of 75 using this particular locomotive. So don't let it trick you into doing that. Because it will not be good news if you do. Again, I'm assuming I'm miles per hour. I know we're in England. Maybe it's kilometers per hour. Either way, don't go over 75. To make it very simple. 3.25 miles to go to our first stop, so I gotta be a little bit mindful of that. Probably gonna stay in the cab the rest of the way. So yeah, I still haven't played Fallout yet. Really, really disappointed on that. Definitely plan to play it, but I'm more interested in taking care of you guys on YouTube first. And then of course we are streaming every Wednesday night, by the way. Make sure to add us on Twitch if you haven't already. Typically me and Frank Wayne do the drone streams. And we've been playing Spin Tires and Construction Simulator as of lately. We also played The Park, which is a horror game that was pretty good. But you never know, might be some more stuff coming up. That's a great liner. Got some alarms coming up, as you can see, so I'm going to stay in cab again until we get to a stop. Got 1.5 miles to go for that. And we have to get down to about 40 miles per hour coming up. Seems like they're going to hit you with all these different things at once to try to get you to mess up. But I'm T-Mag. You guys know this. I don't mess up, right? Sometimes I don't actually. But I try to do 1,000 of 1,000 on each mission. If it's even possible, you know, some of these missions from Don't Tell Games that are impossible to even complete. I should probably start breaking them. Great idea. Jesus. It is the best talking. We're paying attention, right? We barely got it. But maybe if we don't have it, I don't know. That was way too close, I'm not gonna lie. That was like right. If you watch the video over again and want to play this route, that's the latest you can break, period. While still being safe. Because there's lots of brake pressure right there as well, which you have to be careful of. I think it's slow down just a little bit. That was scary. Scaring me inside is what that was doing. Almost to the stopping point here. One more alarm, I believe. There he goes. Let's go ahead and stop. There we go. Again, I have no clue why we're stopping. If I were going to assume anything, it's probably because there's going to be another train passing us, because we're, again, on the service road, access road, whatever you want to call it in a particular language. Some time to take a look at the outside though. So it was nice. Got a little construction crew maybe up there working on some stuff. Let me see if I can pass. Nope, can't pass the signal. And I can only hope that this is not one of those scenarios that's unpassable, which is really weird. I got 1,000 points already. That's definitely scaring me. So it's like, it might be a little teaser, like, you got the 1,000 points, but you can't pass this red light. That'd be horrible if that was the case. Absolutely horrible. Let's see the little guy inside. Look at him. So can't even do my high-pitched voice. It's really bad. Still a little bit sick. No trains coming down here. No trains that way. See, let's go down here and take a look. No? Just kind of like the little blinking red light. It's kind of like Desolate Wonderland is what this is. Oh. My dog's looking at my feet. What up, doggy? What up, dog? I'm trying to record down here, buddy. You're not helping me out. Alright, now I'm getting a little bit worried. I'm still waiting here. Not a train in sight. Maybe I got here too early. I really did get here like 3 minutes before I should have, so. If something was gonna happen, it's gonna happen like the next minute or so. Let's see if I can pass. Still can't pass. It's denied. There's gotta be a train coming from somewhere. That train's stuck on that side too, which is very, very worrying. Very worrying. So I'm gonna have a little coffee break now. No, it doesn't look like coffee, but trust me, it tastes exactly like coffee. I guess I should have made a little cappuccino or something. Yep, this might be one of those scenarios. I could be wasting my time even filming this. Interesting. So the next section is 14.8 miles long. That's a pretty good distance. To the Lockerbie Down loop. Is there anything coming? Oh, I see something. I see something. Oh God. Let's get in. Yes. The scenario might actually work. That looks like a high-speed train right there. Transporting passengers. That's cool. Nice. So that's what we're waiting on. Has to be. There it goes. I feel like I was going faster than him, just saying. I don't know if we had to really wait. And let's see if our signal changes, because we've been sitting here forever. There it goes. Let's get rocking. Start this time. I don't want to go in the red. You can see these little bars right here. And if I remember right, they're not traction bars. It actually has to do with the voltage. Could be wrong. Speed, so let's get up to 75 miles per hour. Is it just me, or is it getting more more foggy outside? It's starting to look like a horror game. I'm waiting for some like zombie to pop out before I get scared the hell out of me. Still run behind the train very closely. It just turned green, so we barely got that alarm. Alright, 13 and 3 quarters of a mile to go to Lockerbie Down loop. Have no clue what's in store moving forward, but We're running at 1,000 of 1,000 points right now, which is a good sign. And assuming T-Mag doesn't jack it up, it might just do okay. What up, son? Europe has a thing against cargo trains. They're very, very short compared to the American cargo. There's probably a good reason for it. Probably the inclines and declines are much greater. Get a couple quick train buys while we got a chance. So far, our arrival and ETA times have been pretty much spot on. That's good. We got to the last stop about 3 minutes earlier, so way ahead of schedule. Right now, it looks like we are actually about 25 seconds ahead of schedule, 27 seconds ahead of schedule or so. Cows to the right. What up? That intersection real quick. Go back in cab for a little bit until I get up to 75. Still running, but you see the double yellows off in the distance right there. Hopefully that turns green so it can make the alarm. Otherwise I have to actually do work. Okay, this actually came a little bit different, but apparently it barely turned green before I hit that the alarm point right there. Just how I like it. You know, I plan that. That's what I do. No, it also looks like it's getting darker outside slowly too. Doing 71 miles per hour. I feel like we went up. Or got up to speed a little bit slowly. But you know, when you're doing the cargo, slow and safe is the way to go. And our ETA again is still pretty good, so not too concerned with that right now. Last video I put up, it's already up to about 9,000 views, which is pretty damn good, in my opinion. People are still watching those videos, which is, to me, a little bit crazy. I watch them now, I don't know why. It's like I got addicted to Train Simulator out of nowhere. I'm sure some of you guys are the same. Very relaxing compared to a lot of games. You know, it's hard for me to go play games like Call of Duty. I like it. You know, Star Wars Battlefront and everything, but there's nothing like sitting back and just kind of relaxing while playing the game. Green light, which is always good. So we're already down to just under 8.5 miles to go. Make a pretty good time doing 70 miles per hour. We're exactly 30 seconds ahead right now. Dog is
taking it. I'm just taking it. I'm just gonna see what happens.
Have to do any power adjustments. You know, I'm not running at 75 miles per hour, but I don't have to do anything. Running at 72 and a half is perfect. Just want to be careful on any declines, though. Make sure it doesn't just suddenly pop up and start gaining speed. 7 miles to go. Probably should get in a couple train bys while I still got a chance before I get a little too close to the end of the scenario here. Yeah, not much scenery. It's pretty barren. Not to say that it's bad, but it is what it is. Next side, that's my favorite train by right there. I need to do one of those. I hate the overhead. This would be considered an overhead right here. So she had a bunch of different angles with that reset, that'd be awesome. Go. Let's get back in the cab. I'm afraid I'm going to miss an alarm getting too close to the train in front of me. Miles to go. go. Go ahead and get on a 40 miles per hour real quick. Got a whistle board as well. Slightly above the arrival time. Taking my sweet time, which I shouldn't do. Go. Almost to lock me down loop right here. Good stopping point for the scenario, and hopefully again I got 1,000 we'll see what happens. ETA is definitely rising up slightly. But as long as it's within the minute, you're okay. That should be it. Hopefully. No, I'm not. Oh, there it goes. All right, well done. You have a scheduled wait here, so this is as far as you go for now. Hope the snow did not cause too many problems, which it didn't. Bam! Oh, and I just passed 30 for once. I was stuck at 30 for like 40 scenarios, if you didn't notice. Now they actually fixed the career tracking, thank God. So, big shout out to Blackhawken right there. Or Blackhawk, whatever you want to say. Got 1,000 on this route as well. Surprised more friends haven't played it, which is a bit strange. There we go. That's me on the global list right there. It's always good. So 1,000 of 1,000 points. Gained a rank. I mean, I couldn't be happier, honestly. So this is definitely going on YouTube. You'll definitely be watching this at some point. Anyways, appreciate all you guys watching Middle Age Gamer. Please, again, subscribe to both YouTube and Twitch. And feel free to watch the Twitch live streams every Wednesday night starting around 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. I'll check you guys next time. Peace.